I'm making this video on a fig tree in Mesa, and I'm going to start by showing you this limb. This limb is on the outer part of the tree, and it's died back, and some of it's been cut off. Now, if we look at this tree, we can see that large portions of it are starting to die. And this fungus that is in the tree has progressed quite rapidly. Within a week or two, it was first noticed a week ago, or a week and a half ago. And when we first noticed it, it was just this one limb. And now we have more of the tree that's affected. And what I'm going to do in this video is identify the disease, show how it has progressed, explain why, and then tell you what we're going to do to treat it. Now, I first noticed this. I haven't ran into this too many times. Maybe only two or three in the last 20 years. That's not to say that there haven't been more than that, but I've only been called out on two or three fig trees that were as bad as this. And one I treated, maybe 5 years ago. You see the top, how it's dying off. You see how this is starting to die up here. Here, the one I treated 5 years ago, I treated that aggressively with a fungicide. And I came and cut back the affected parts. And I came back a year later and it was doing well. And that's the only one I ever treated that I got back to. I think I treated one other fig tree either before that or after that. So, I don't really have the one that I know about that we treated. What I did was correct, and it resulted in the tree recovering. Now, this happens to be my own tree, and I was busy reading up on citrus disease and ignoring this until it got to the point where, there's a possibility I might lose this tree. Now, the first tree couple of trees I treated, I knew it was a fungus, but I didn't really know which one. I just knew, was able to identify it as a fungus, and treated it as such. And as a result, it worked. What I did for it worked. But I really had to do some digging. And I mean a lot of digging. I've spent maybe 10 hours on the internet, finally satisfying myself to the name of this particular fungus and how it progresses. Now, the common name for it is limb blight. The affected limbs wilt rapidly. The fungus enters at a spot along the main or secondary limbs and all leaves die beyond that point. Now, the fungus enters at a dead fruiting spore or at some other injured spot. Now you can see those little spores. And here's one of our culprits that spread the fungus. And some of those spots that they enter into have a kind of a sap-like substance coming out of them. And then as it progresses, there's a little stink bug egg. I found stink bugs on this tree, and that's one of the insects that's driving this fungus. But the main spread of this fungus, as I have observed it, is through the dripping of the fruit. If you look at this particular piece of fruit, and you see that there's little ants on it. See if I can get a better picture of this in the light. Okay, that you should be able to see without. And there's ants crawling out of that. And even the fruit that isn't ripe or doesn't appear to be ripe, if you look at it, it's got the fungus on it. Okay. Now, on some of these, when they reach a certain level of ripeness, the fruit becomes infected with ants. And so the two ways this fungus is spreading on this tree, I believe, is that number one, the ants are crawling up and down the tree. And the second way is the fruit above is rotting, and as it falls, this little piece right here, that's yesterday's fruit that's fallen on the tree, either because a bird ate it or because the fruit just rotted and fell. And as it fell, the fungus that was in the fruit that was brought there either by the rain originally, or now it's being brought by all the ants as they walk back and forth, drops on the rest of the tree. Now, the limb blight really affects the branch collar to some degree or another. And as you can see on this branch collar, you can see signs of the black fungus, which looks just like a rust. Any of the rust that I investigated in that family of fungus didn't cause the dieback to the figs like this does. So regardless of whether it's the limb blight and that family of fungus, which is also known as pink disease on rubber trees, cocoa, pink disease on citrus, pink disease on oleanders, pink disease on black peppers and pink disease on trees, which are other synonyms for limb blight. It's also known as twig blight. Whether it's that or some other kind of fungus, it doesn't really matter at this point, because we're going to treat it as if it's a fungus that is being spread not only by the fruit dropping, but by the ants that are crawling up and down this tree, and by a small amount by the stink bugs. So what we're going to do here is, and if you happen to have this, I'm going to follow this. This is just the first video. We're kind of in the diagnostic state. Is we're going to remove all of the damaged limbs, all of the dead limbs, not all the damaged ones, because there wouldn't be anything left. Every limb has this stuff on it. But all the ones that are dead, we're going to take out of here. And we're also going to remove all of the fruit. Then we're going to treat this with an organic fungicide that I, when I get ready to do that, I'll make another video. And we're going to do that once or twice, and then we're going to treat it with a different type of organic fungicide, which is basically made from fish oil, and we're going to do that weekly for a while, and then we're going to do that every, then we're going to see what happens, whether we can stop it or not, whether we can stop the dieback. And if we can, then that'll be pretty good, because every limb on this tree is infected, and it's going fast. So we're either going to be able to fix this, or not. And if we can fix this one, we should be able to take care of any of them, unless they're way worse than this. Okay. Now you can see the streaking black on this, how it's been spread. And they say this is either done, it's either spread by splashing water, rain, or insects. And I found a few stink bugs on here, but not enough to spread this fungus. But there's lots of ants, and the birds eat the fruit, and it drops. And some of the fruit hasn't ripened at all. Usually we get really good fruit off of this. And some of it that's ripe is just, as soon as it gets ripe, it's full of ants. And that wouldn't normally be a problem if this fungus weren't involved, okay? In the normal course of things, the ants are going to eat the figs and then they're going to be gone, and, you know. But in this case, got a fungus that's being spread. It was either brought in by birds or the rain. That's my guess. And then, because this hasn't been here before. And the ants have always been eating the figs when they get ripe. So the fungus was brought in somehow, or it could have come in from something that's on my trailer that somebody else had that I drug over to my yard, you know. But it happened right after we got our first rain, so I'm blaming it on the rain. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. And then, once it got introduced, the insects just spread it around. So if we get rid of the fruit, that part of it will no longer be an issue. So I'll be picking fruit out here tomorrow morning. And I'll get the pole saw and I'll sterilize it first. Always sterilize your tools. And we'll get all the fruit off. And then we'll get all the dead branches off. And then I ordered Captain Jack's bug spray, which I normally don't use. I usually use a more mild one. But I'm going to get it. It's all organic too, but one of the substances is a little more toxic than what I like to use on a regular basis. But I'm going to use it on this one. And I'm going to spray that, and then the next day or two I'm going to spray it with the Organicide 3-in-1, which you can get from Home Depot. And I might even inject this tree. I probably will, just because I usually, when I'm doing something for the first time and I don't really have any experience in how things are going to work out, I usually throw everything that I can at the problem. So I will inject this with a fungicide, and I will get rid of the fruit, and I will get rid of the dead limbs and open it up a little bit, even though we're into our 112 degree weather here in Mesa, Arizona. I'm going to open this up a little bit, and probably before I do anything, I'm going to put some soapy water in here and really wash it off, maybe with four or five sprays. And then after that dries out a little bit, I'll do that in the early morning. And when that dries out, then I'll hit it with Captain Jack stuff. And then on the next day, I'll hit it with the Organicide 3-in-1. And then I'll watch it. I'll go down and I'm out of the capsules for the fungicide. The fungicide that I put in fruit trees is not a true fungicide. It spurs the tree's ability to fight fungus, but it doesn't put anything harmful into the tree. And I'm going to do that, and then we'll see what happens. And what I'm not going to do, which is recommended by everybody, is spray this with a copper fungicide. And the reason I'm not going to do that is because anybody that reads the fine print on any of the copper fungicides, like Bordeaux and the things that mimic Bordeaux that use talc and a small amount of copper, that product causes permanent, irreversible eye damage. And I just don't do stuff like that. I'm almost 70 years old, and my eyes are fine, and I don't do anything that's going to, it's dangerous enough, the stuff that I do when I get up in trees and stuff. I don't need to be adding to that. I made a decision, about 50 years ago that I wasn't going to get up in trees and spray anymore. I just wasn't going to do it. And I'm certainly not going to spray or encourage anybody else to spray as a solution on something that, if they get just a little bit careless, can permanently, irreversibly damage their eyes. You know, and if you read the fine print, it talks about permanently, irreversibly blinding somebody. So I'm just not going to do that. There's fungicides that I can inject directly into the tree that aren't going to get on me. And the other organic products have properties that are antifungal. And if that doesn't work, then it just doesn't work. And I'll plant a fast-growing lemon tree here to, you know, to shield this part of the house. So that's it for now. This is video one of saving the fig tree. If you have problems like this, or with any kind of tree disease problems, most of the tree disease problems I've seen a bunch of times. It's just that I haven't encountered this very often when somebody's called me out to fix their trees. But if you have problems with your fig trees, give us a call at Warner's Tree Surgery. If you're anywhere close to Mesa, Arizona, you know, within 20 or 30 miles of Mesa, the number is 480-969-8808. And my wife, Pat, will set you up with a bed, and I'll come out and take a look at it. So, I'm going to sign off now.